Dr. Quinn, first of all, can you define the NBA bubble for us?
I mean, the NBA bubble, this is so exciting. It's basically an enclosed environment where all the participants in the games, they live, they practice, and they play. And basically, they're going to resume and complete the 2019-2020 NBA season. Now, this NBA bubble, it was derived from a 113-page document that was produced by NBA leadership in close collaboration with medical experts. And the whole purpose was to design a scenario that was as safe as possible for the players and everyone involved. But there are a lot of different protocols and guidelines. And one of the protocols that I like is the fact that everybody is housed at the Orlando, Florida Disneyland Resort. Poor guys. But it's gonna be exciting.
Now, what is the protocol for going into and coming out of the bubble?
Yes, that protocol is very interesting. When the players arrived, and they're already there, they're practicing right now. LeBron James is slamming on somebody. But the deal is they had to stay in their rooms for 48 hours, 2 days, and take 2 tests that were negative. And once determined negative, they could leave their rooms and participate. But also, there are 3 ways you can leave. Number one, you can be eliminated because you don't meet enough, you don't win enough games. That might happen to, I'm not gonna say who, but the number 2 way you leave is you can get what's called approved to leave. Say, for instance, your wife has a child or somebody's sick, you can get approved to leave, but while you're gone, you have to test every single day wherever you are in the world, and then when you return, you're quarantined to your room for 4 days. You have to do 4 negative tests to be released to resume back in the games. The third way you can leave is unexcused leave. If that happens, when you return, you have to do 10 days of testing. And at that point, if it's negative after 10 days, you can return to play. But note, you're gonna miss a lot of games and you probably won't be getting paid. Now, I also want to note that the Disneyland employees, to include the cooks, the waiters, the waitresses, the servers, the room cleaners, they don't have to stay. They can leave, go home every night, come back when their shift starts, but they have to wear a mask, they have to wear gloves, and they can't get no closer than 6 feet from the player. Also wanted to note that, you know, that the family is gonna be able to come on August the 30th. Note that's 50 days from when they were separated from their husbands for the wives. And they're gonna have to go through very specific protocols as well. But I can tell you, these guys can have a lot of discipline because I couldn't be away from my wife for 50 days. I wouldn't be able to make one shot, but I can't shoot anyway, so it doesn't matter.
Melissa, well, many NBA players are millionaires, they're used to the finer things. What's day-to-day life like for them?
Right, well, the bottom line is they're gonna have a lot of amenities. They'll be able to go on the rides at Disney World. They're gonna have trails, golf courses, everything that they need. But the bottom line is the NBA is gonna start back up and it's gonna be great.
All right, Dr. Timothy Quinn, practicing family medicine in Richland. Thanks for spending some time with us this afternoon.
Hey, thank you.
You're watching 12 News.